In this video, I'm going to tell you about a couple of bugs I found in Toast 20 Titanium and Toast 20 Pro. I put some timestamps in the description in case you want to jump around. The first bug we're going to talk about is something that I call the DVD menu highlight bug. And this seems to affect only Toast 20 Titanium, at least the latest version of it. What happens is you create your DVD menu as you do. You burn your disc as you do. Everything works great. You play it back on your computer, on your Mac. Works fine. As you highlight the different chapters that you may have put in your video, you can see which one is selected and you can press the button to play just that particular section. However, when you take your disc and you stick it into a dedicated DVD or Blu-ray player like a PlayStation or a dedicated device, you may discover that the highlight color is nowhere to be found. So you put in the disc, the menu works as before. However, as you press to select different sections on the DVD menu, you can't tell what's being selected. So that's an issue that a couple of you have reported to me. It's something that I've seen. It only affects Titanium. Toast 20 Pro seems to work the way that you might expect. The second bug I'm going to tell you about is something that I call the Blu-ray menu highlight bug. And this seems to affect both Toast Titanium with the Blu-ray plugin, as well as Toast 20 Pro, which includes a Blu-ray plugin. So the actual functionality of the app is exactly the same for creating DVDs or Blu-rays. However, when you burn your Blu-ray, you may discover that when you put it into your Blu-ray player, that your video plays per normal. However, as you press the buttons to select different sections, different bookmarks, you'll see overlaid over the live video of your disc, the different chapter menus that you've specified. I've confirmed that this works in both versions of Toast. And if you want to see what this looks like on your Mac and maybe you don't have a Blu-ray player, you can use the VLC app, which is available at videoland.org. Download that for free and you can use that to open the disc and see what it looks like right on your Mac. The next thing we're going to talk about is not really a bug. It's something that's by design, but I'm going to call it the DVD menu container. And what that means is when you use Toast to create a DVD menu with chapters, that chapter, the whole thing becomes contained within the title of your video. So the first item in your chapter screen will play the entire video and all of the other chapter items show up side by side. I've had a few people ask me whether it's possible to have one button that plays the entire disc and another button that's dedicated to showing the chapters on their own page. I haven't found a way to do that. It doesn't seem as though Toast is designed to work that way. And then the next thing we're going to talk about is something that I'm going to call text support. What I've discovered is that with text support, you can actually go to Roxio.com, and under Roxio.com, you can find a Corel agent to get text support for Toast 20, whether it's Titanium or Pro. There are two types of support that are available. The first one is live chat, which only works during certain hours. And the second one is an email support. Now, in both of these, you'll need to have your serial number and maybe even the order number to prove that you purchased the versions of the apps before they'll give you support, which is fine. What I've discovered is that for most of the issues that I have, it takes anywhere between 2 to 4 days for me to get from the beginning to the end. So I actually have about 4 tickets that are open right now on various topics. And I'm finding that no matter how many tickets I have, no matter which ones are open, I always seem to be getting the same agent responding to me, which is fine. Nothing against that agent. Congratulations on all your hard work. But what it seems to tell me is that the support team is rather small. So if you need immediate help, tech support might not be the fastest way to get it, which is kind of unfortunate. And then the last thing I want to talk to you guys about is the 30-day money-back guarantee. I have advised a few people based on what it is they were trying to accomplish that if they purchased Toast and they were still within the 30-day window, they should seek a reimbursement if they're finding that the app isn't working the way they would like it to. And so far, everyone that I've referred who's decided to take advantage of the 30-day money-back guarantee has reported back that they were able to get a full refund for their price. So I'll drop a link to that in the description so that you can go back. And if you are within the 30 days of your purchase, you can get your money back. As for me, I've been using Toast for a long, long time. I started using Toast Titanium a couple years ago. And so I bought it then. So I'm well outside of the 30-day. And because I wanted to understand how Blu-rays worked, I also bought a Blu-ray burner and I bought the Blu-ray plugin for Toast Titanium. And then just recently I bought Toast 20 Pro so I could see how they're different. And what I discovered is you can't run both versions of Toast on the same Mac at the same time. In order for me to run Toast 20 Pro on my Mac, I had to completely uninstall Toast Titanium. So one of the tickets I have open right now is seeing whether I can get another download link, because the installer that I have for Toast Titanium doesn't seem to work anymore, which is great. Anyway, are you using Toast Titanium or Toast 20? Do you have any bugs that you'd like to share with me? Perhaps we might be able to get the folks over at Roxio to provide us some solutions and some updates. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.